inspiration comes from my children. And just seeing the joy that a picture could bring to some people, because it's not words. You know, you're looking at an image, and it can bring on so much emotion, especially if you dig deep, and the picture really say something to you. Just seeing that on somebody's face, that inspires me to paint more and dig deeper into your imagination, because you know, you never know how you can touch somebody just by expressing yourself. So that's what inspired. As I went on to school, my art teachers, they inspired me. They saw a gift, as they called it. And, especially Mr. Howley, my high school art teacher. He actually knew he was talking about, and he actually could draw. And he inspired me to go on and perfect my craft. As far as my future with art, you know, just knowing that that I can make a living off of it if I strive for it, you know, it does give me a good feeling, because people always want art. You know, they always want some decor in their room. They always want some kind of self-expressionism hanging around them. People want to be inspired. So as long as I keep painting, you know, just keep being productive, keep the reason why Picasso was so great is because, what's the word? He was prolific. You know, he had a lot of paintings. He painted every day. Van Gogh, all them, they did a painting a day. No matter what it was. Writers, they write every day. People who play sports, they play every day. That's how they get better. You know what I mean? So as long as I keep painting, for the next 10 years, I'm trying to be on some billboards or something. Trying to see me, my paintings in. You know, on the front of a magazine, just in the background, hanging on the wall. You know what I mean? That's where I see it. This modern day black renaissance, it all, like I said, in the beginning it was about expression. And the way they expressed themselves back then was different than how we express ourselves now. It's a lot more media coverage now, it's a lot more social networks. Everybody is making a brand for themselves. But with the black renaissance, I see it as everybody coming together and expressing themselves as one. Even if they're doing it individually, you do it together. Keep it all in the family, in the black community, for others to view as a whole. They see us as the movement. You know, they see the black people expressing themselves, saying what they think, saying what how they live. And it's not all negative. Even if it is negative, you turn it into positive. You know what I mean? And you see the light in that darkness. And, you know, you just, you know, it brings joy. You know, you can laugh, you can cry. You know, you play the blues, you play the loud hip hop, you play, you draw the smiles, you draw the tears, you know what I mean? You draw the big loud words. It's really just about expressing yourself and coming together as one. A choice of one easy woman at a time. I'll take three the hard way. All Wine and Words was a collaboration of the minds. Josh Austin, myself, and a couple other young up-and-coming artists. It was poetry, we had art on the walls, we had free wine tasting. It was just something different for the city and for the community. I had my art on display. We did some spoken word, some revolutionary spoken word. To reach me, you can email me at DavonCarey@me.com. You can see most of my artwork on Instagram, just at Davon Carey.